The new version of Drupal 10 is coming this December 2022. And if you're currently working on Drupal 7 or even Drupal 9, it's time to start planning the updates. Drupal is one of the most enterprise-ready and open-source content management systems, powering websites like Tesla and Verizon or Stanford University. So we'll look in this video at the five major changes that this new Drupal 10 version will bring and how you can get ready, because it's important that you don't get left behind. As a software engineer or a full-stack developer, as you know, you always need to continually improve your digital platform to stay secure, to keep the performance and the accessibility. So this video will hopefully help you stay ahead of the game. And make sure you watch until the end, where I'll give you a few tips if you are struggling to convince your boss or your marketing manager that they need to invest in this upgrade and avoid running unsupported and outdated content management system. Let's get to it. Hey, welcome back. I'm Sylvain Reiter, and I'm here to help you become the hero of your next digital project by making better decisions and continuing to grow your career in digital. So last year, Dries Boyaert, the founder and lead developer of the Drupal content management system, presented a roadmap for Drupal, which was backed by extensive research, and he outlined five strategic goals. So let's go through them one by one. First would be the Drupal 10 readiness. Because as an open source content management system, Drupal is using a lot of third-party components from the wider community, such as Symfony, CK Editor, and PHP. So Drupal 10 needs to align with the latest version of PHP 8 and Symfony and all those components. The 6 months delay we've seen recently in the Drupal of release of Drupal 10 is largely down to the need to develop a migration path for the content that was created with the CK Editor plugin from version 4 to 5. So this will be a major milestone when this is ready in a few months. And second is the project browser. And this update will bring easier option to search and install the thousands of third-party modules and add-ons that you can add as an additional feature to your core content management system. Because at the moment, the developers just know the most popular module and they have to install them manually and they just know where to look for on the main Drupal website. So this new interface will be integrated directly with the admin area, and longer term there will be a powerful search engine with categories and hopefully allow a one-click installation for some of those. My view is that it's a step in the right direction, but it's not going to be a magic solution, because when you run a large website ecosystem, it will still require technical configuration and a proper release and change management workflow, as well as thorough testing to make sure that any new module that you install, any new plugin, does not break the rest of your website. Can't take that risk. The third would be automatic updates. And Drupal Security Group is recognized by most of the community as very proactive and efficient when it comes to patching the vulnerabilities to the core framework. However, third-party modules from the community are not their responsibilities, and most of those become unmaintained over time and open huge security risks to your website. The current aim of the Automatic Update Initiative is to apply the Drupal core patches and security only, and it's not clear whether that will include security updates or just those approved by the Drupal core team. And doing the automatic updates brings a lot of complexity that shouldn't be underestimated, because you have to check after the automatic updates and make sure that nothing is broken or that you might need to roll back. So again, large corporate ecosystem will need a dedicated team to monitor this manually. Fourth is the easy out of the box. As a content management system, Drupal has a steep learning curve, but it can scale very well to enterprise solution and deliver global websites better than most other platforms. We're currently building an academy in my company for training. And even our own developers admit that it has a steep learning curve and they struggle to learn it at the beginning when they were junior developers. But the more they use it, the more complex features they need to build, the more they love it. And this easy out-of-the-box initiative aims to smoothen this initial onboarding with a nicer default theme like Claro for the users or Olivero for the administrators. And they will be more accessible and more performant and easier to use. And it will be simpler for developers as well to build custom themes on top of it that will bring a lot of SEO benefits as well. The new CK Editor, for example, will remove the H1 tag because there should only be one on the page, and that will come from the page title in Drupal. It will have, finally, we'll be able to manage lazy loading for the images directly in the CMS. So I think we should all enable that as the default feature everywhere. And 5 would be the decoupled menu. This final initiative has confused many of my coworkers, but it could have quite a big impact for the new headless trends that is taking the web development community by storm. Because it will help to provide a more consistent experience for JavaScript developers by reusing existing React components, for example, and the robust Drupal API that we can build on top of other frameworks without needing a Drupal theme for every website. It started with a navigation element as a proof of concept, but it will hopefully roll out to contents and maybe forms, and we'll see where it goes in future iterations. So those are the 5 main changes that we are expecting to come in Drupal 10, with some of them already being available as work in progress or preview in Drupal 9.4, so you can check it out today. I've not seen many updates about future upgrade for the media library, where there is some need to clear up the confusion around the media entities, the file, the images, and how it could become more consistent and better work with content moderation. So again, we'll see. Don't forget to subscribe to follow up for more details when those are released. Now for the bonus material I promised you. If you're still running on a Drupal 6 or Drupal 7 website, you really need to wake up! Drupal 7 will be end of life in November 2023, in less than just over a year. And migration is really painful. You cannot really avoid it. So if you need your boss to invest into a revamp and the upgrade, there are 3 main arguments you could use. The first one is that you cannot run your Drupal platform, your main digital ecosystem, with security vulnerabilities. No one can take the risk of getting hacked these days. And with all the sensitive data you might be hosting on the forums and impact your brand reputation, it's just not an option. Second, it's more than the technical upgrade. Maybe it's time to revamp the front end of your website as well to comply with the latest accessibility guideline or the SEO requirements to ensure that your website keeps performing. And third, you need to think about your editors as well and give them a modern and accessible content management system that will make their life much easier to manage all the content and the assets for their website. So if this still does not work and you can't still convince your boss or your client that they need to upgrade, reach out and we'll try to paint a darker scenario to convince them. That's it for today. I want to say a huge shout out to my colleague Duncan Worrell for his impressive research that inspired this video and the entire write-up that he did around Drupal 10. So thanks, Duncan. If you have any questions about the Drupal CMS or any other digital transformation project you may be working on, feel free to reach out by leaving some comments below or online on Twitter, for example. If you need help selecting your next CMS, you can watch this video about the Drupal upgrade recommendation. I hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to keep learning with me and grow your career in digital. Until next time, keep up the good work, stay safe, and see you soon.